Right, we're going to be looking at a bit of block-based programming to get started. So we're going to be using a program that looks an awful lot like Scratch, but it's called BYOB. You'll notice you'll find it on your desktop by searching for an icon that looks like this guy here. Now we're going to be looking at something called an if statement, so a conditional statement. Now, to start that, you got to go to your control, and every single program actually needs to have something that starts it. So I'm going to use the space bar for mine. So every time I press the space key, my program is going to get started. Now, within that if statement, there's a couple of different options you can choose. You could use a forever if, an if, or the more advanced if else. Now, if you're looking through these programs, you can group these into two things. A conditional loop, because that's going to run forever if that condition is true, or conditional statements, which is the if and the if else that runs a single item of code once if the statement is true. So I'm going to look at that if statement, and you'll notice that when you drop it in, it has kind of a box that looks like this. So it actually asks it questions. You got to actually check something. So you go to the operators, and you have these three operators here, where you check if the numbers are less than, equal than, or greater than. Those are the simple ones. You also have things like true and false. So if you want to always run, you can make it true. So I'm just going to do something nice and simple just to test if it works. I'm just going to have it turn 15 degrees. So now, every time I press the space key, because this condition is true, it's going to turn 15 degrees. So you can start to see he's turning 15. And of course, you can change that so you can make him spin in a circle. So every time you press the space bar, it does it rapidly quick so you can't actually see it. It does actually turn. So let's actually make that half a circle. Flips upside down. There we go. So now we can get him spinning. But maybe we don't want him to spin all the time. And that's worth going back those comparison operators where they compare two things to get a true or false answer comes in handy. So if we take that out, I'm going to use less than. And I'm going to make it something is less than 10. Now, it could be anything. You can put in a number, say 1. So as long as this is a true statement, he's going to turn. So 1 is less than 10. So I press the space key, you can see he's turning. But you can also do things like going into the sensing and you can ask questions. So you could be asking the user questions like, what is a number? And check what their answer is. So let's ask them that question now. So guess a number. And as long as that number is less than 10, it's going to spin. See, I press the space button. Guess his number, so I'm going to do 15. Oh, it doesn't spin. If I guess 5, well, I know 5 is less than 10, so we're going to see it move. You can also, instead of, say, using answer, you can go back to those operators, and you can add a bit of randomness. So instead of asking the user for something, I could have it randomly move. So maybe instead of between 1 and 10, it's 1 and 20. So there's a 50% chance, because half these numbers are not less than 10, that it's actually going to spin. And that's where that if else comes in. Because you can see sometimes I'm pressing it. You can see it's being highlighted. But sometimes it's not actually spinning. So you can actually go and you can use that if else statement. And I want you to have a bit of a try and see what happens if you have it set up like this. So what would your program look like? What is that purpose of that else statement?